Drifting to bed crying, you had no wish to harm. Ronald Ryan, you're doing time. You were the charm. On a road near condemnation, church house and fell. The breakout you were making would take you straight back to hell. But you'll find that thing around.
America. When's it go?
Half past four.
Here it is. Nick. Nick, what's that? It's coming in.
But we're going out.
Someone's coming.
I had a mate who's had it going steady, but now he's not. It's you, not him, right?
That's right, Ron. I can't do no more can.
Hey, no man can.
Time is right. Be ready.
Brazil is imminent. Because. Years. Or 800. What's the difference?
I'm a man of action, Dorothy.
I'm gonna fly over that tower, you girl. Don't know what divorce you're talking about. Governor reckons I'm a top bloke. He'll vouch for me. I'll be a top bloke again in South America. We'll meet up in the jungle if necessary. Come back to Australia loaded! Ha ha ha! Crawl mustache, they won't know me. Couple of coconuts for breakfast. Just like Melbourne. Only they laugh over there. Could do with a laugh. Not much fun in here. Fancy staying here the rest of your life. Rotten. Why do it? Why bother? In 10 years, just for walking through a nice warehouse, quiet as a mop, with a rifle. Neat. Jesus, it's got to me. Believe it, let go. You're not meant to fail, let go of you. When I'm older, let go of me. Shooting pigs going grey.
Listen to the screams.
Guzzling the beer. Can't run up. It's going to work. I feel it. I know it. I can trust him. He's fit. Into the car park and hot wire anything to get out of here. The least I could have done was let my three daughters write to me. When we met, what we said, when we wed. Where are you? Where are you?
Hard to get. Who's coming over?
I want
Hawthorne.
What are you doing?
I went with my dad.
All right. What does he do?
He builds houses.
Yeah? He build you? I mean, you're pretty deadly, aren't you? Well, listen here. Well, I'm afraid you'll have to marry me now, Dorothy.
Why?
Well, it's the last train back to Footscray. I'll have to walk.
How many trams do you need to get to Mother and Father's? How many trams from your boarding house to our mansion?
Let's see. First there's that Footscray one at Sid, Plymouth Street. And then you have to wait an eternity for either the Wattle Park or Glenferrie Ray. Now, whatever, they're all green, aren't they?
But now it's just the last one. What am I going to do? Walk back to Footscray? I will.
I mean, I'm so fit, I'll probably have to skip the jump all the way back home. Right? I'm a champion biker, I mean. Yeah. Or cups, gold ones. Melt them down into a front gate or
what? Oh, stop it, I'll wet myself.
Don't do that.
Oh, melt it, I'll come into a front gate. Why do you say things like that?
I don't know why I say things like that. Just for fun.
Oh, you're for fun, all right. I defy mother. I'm bad, aren't I, Ronnie? So bad.
Otherwise, you'll go under. Well, no.
We won't go under, my love.
Really? It's hard. It's hard, you know, when you're 22 and too old to push bike.
I say that a push bike, what are you saying there?
Well, I could ride my bike, Dan, but I look a bit like a goose.
Put a shell in it.
Like that?
Right.
Open it. Yeah.
I'm not gonna do this. I'm not gonna shoot you, mate. It's too bloody hot. Just open the gate and we'll get on great. Don't fucking me around. Move. Don't. Which gate? Ground floor, ladies' lingerie. Out here, Myers, lady. Come on, Prince. This is your first day or something. Undo the wicked gate.
Come on, mate. Get your chair.
Move. What did you want? A green light? Oh, wait on. Wrong gate, you dog. Open the right gate or someone's gonna find you white somewhere. In Germans, mate, get out of here! Move out! Right gate, mate! Don't disappoint me, you think this is Bush Week! We're all going to Brazil! Back! Where's all the cops? Normally there's a car, but 100 wireless cars are here. Cats are everywhere, man. Cats are
everywhere. Lady, where's
your own hand? Who's this now, one?
I'm an old soldier.
Who are you?
Fuck me, Jeff.
Christ, you sound too hot, don't you? Shoot him! I hardly know him.
He might be as useless as a hostage.
I wouldn't get you too bot for him. I'll pray for both of them.
Not another Bible basher. Get out of bloody road.
What are you shooting?
Yeah, I'll do it.
You stupid old prick. You can't help me. I'm sorry. Come back, mate.
Right.
What do you know? Something to read on the banana boat.
Yeah.
Go!
coppers.
I'll remember you said that.
My old lady and old man were closet drinkers. They used to prop me up at the end of the table all night sipping 10 Bob Horror. I suppose it was like watching TV. I think then.
Suppose I love him. I reckon Winnie was the best of the lot, mate. We're all a bit Winnie, aren't we?
The mighty Murrumbidgee. Clean, faithful, like Dorothy, before we got greedy.
Fucking wish to marry a tram conductor. Sleep, mate, late. In the morning I'll find your tram conductors.
Night, mate.
Night, mate.
Several years. How do you know what to say when you live like us?
Mother thinks you're American.
Well, honestly, I don't know how she came to that.
I mean, I've always liked her.
The clothes don't matter.
Yes, they do.
My family is straight left-side.
Your old man is the mayor of Auckland, is he?
Well, a man has to do something with his time.
My love to you is something of my time.
Do you love me?
Yeah, I do.
Even though you work Olympic ties in foot scrap.
Especially because...
I love you. I really do. Oh, you're peculiar.
I promise I'll keep with the friends that you're expected.
Oh, God bless you, Ron.
Someone has to.
Boarding house.
Well, I was first at the family pie last night.
and got 11 forks in the back of my hand.
It's competitive,
then. Oh, yeah, you could say that. Jeez, it's hot in here. Can we open the window?
Yeah.
Don't pick on her.
Are you of rural origin?
Yeah. The old man's a timber cutter when he hasn't got the horrors.
I'm hallucinating.
Not really. He hates it when he sobers up. Been doing it too long.
Work is such war.
He taught me to do any tree felling, charcoal burning, timber cutting, fox skinning, hobnobbing.
Is there much demand for fox skinning?
Do you take coffee, Rob?
Where do I take it? Back to the boarding house?
I'm dying to tell you.
Yeah, I'd love a cup of coffee, Mr. George. Where'd it come from?
And jar.
Jar! So long as he brings a plate, he's a white man, isn't he?
What? How familiar to open the windows. Into a better world.
I quite like this one. I don't know a better one.
There isn't one.
Father, could we possibly turn Mozart down? Hey,
don't bother. I'm beginning to like it. You know, Mozart was a moulder.
It must be hard to be caught by trap.
I always stand up for the women.
That's because he's a gent. She's my only daughter.
I'm her only man.
You're wonderful.
So, what do you think of the ruling class?
Don't think of them.
Just you. Me. You're the first aristocrat I ever met.
They're not bad people. Dad makes decent choices.
Sure he does.
He likes you.
Well, I'll live with him then.
Mother takes a little knitting you to
choose. So does Dad. Enough of that, Charlie. I mean, you know I'll do the right thing by you. Engaging, bringing dumplings. Your mother will see it before you do. Your father likes me. All your mother needs is a heart. Dad worships you, doesn't he, Dorothy?
She does.
Well, ready to get going. I'm off like a Bondi.
What does that mean?
Ha ha! Oh, you privileged hawthorn shield.
Remember, Ronald Ryan.
Indonesia. Has he got any rat? Does it go?
How much did it cost?
Been flashing it, mate?
Oh, I love flash. Nothing wrong with it, fellas. Hop in. The last bloke who had it didn't want to get rid of it.
Probably because he pinched it. Kiss the keys. Get down the road.
Oh, right.
That was Presley probably drove this thing, right?
Here's the keys. You drive. Hop in. Let's go.
Two failures, believed to be Patrick Desmond-Keys, Ronald Ryan and Peter Walker, escaped with over £4,000 in cash.
Whatever you do, don't go and chat that radio with him.
Yeah, well, I'll make sure he doesn't transmit fucking anything.
Let's bring back the grog, nothing else, right?
You right? What are you hanging around for? What are you talking to him for? Let's go get the grog, let's have a party.
Say it all the way later!
Hey, well, I made Fisherback and Christine's reckons that monkey man was Ronald Ryan.
That's correct.
He's worth £5,000 reward money. We're considering putting him into the cops. You want to be in it?
Yeah.
What a bad idea, mate.
You reckon it's him, do you? You sure?
Yeah. Johnny was in Bendigo training prison with him. He knows him. They sniff each other's parts like dogs out there.
Nah, I'm not sure you're right, mate.
Nah, not that bloke. He's too ordinary looking. Like a timber cutter or a Islamic bloke. Amazing, isn't it? What luck! This has fallen right out of the blue on me. Truck pushing tow trucks for a living.
No, mate. You're wrong. You're quite wrong. Wrong, Edison.
Listen, who are you?
I'm his mate, Peter Walker.
How you going? Let's just drive around for a while. I need to catch my breath.
Come in.
Come here.
Here's 400 quid. Think about this. Forget about Ryan.
Look, I need to take a leak. Come into the day with me, will you? Put that water away, you're making me chummy. I won't tell me anyway. I'll have my eye on you, pal. You've been hanging around my girl, mate, have you? And your mate, Ryan. He's been giving a tour as well, has he? I'll come on, confess that you'll be jailed. You don't scare me. Before I quit my ass. Who do you think you are, God? I'm gonna fix you up.
Is that right? I'm shaking. I'm fucking shaking.
Oh,
so, you reckon I look like your chauffeur?
Hurry up the jeeps and don't spare the horses. See if you can get to Albury in 15 minutes.
Next stop, Sydney, Ronald.
Yeah.
Women, Rose Hill, new bag of fruit, hinge, immortality.
Mate, it's cops. Wave to him.
Hey, wait.
Not be all lonely on his pat alone. They wouldn't know if you were up. Hang on. He wants us to pull over.
I better run him over there.
No. Just pull up this big car.
Where are we off to?
Rose Hill. Who do you like in the fourth race?
Rose Hill. All the way to Sydney for a race.
Very comfortable, man. Otherwise, we'd come with you. Would we not?
Would you like to see my license, officer? Been your chauffeur for a very long time. Been through a lot together, haven't we, mate?
Yes.
All those campaigns.
I'm jealous of you. Some people hardly work for their money.
Go on. Did you go, you lucky bastard?
Not so fast.
This one. It looks like Michael Caine. In the outfit.
His brother.
Sugar.
Boy?
Yes, sir.
Sydney now. Take it to the cross. I'm desirous of a schooner of old.
That's not so wrong. I love Sydney. It's going to be lucky for us, mate. You say that'll be? It's like a sea change. Fresh oxygen. Jesus Christ. Freedom. Lost.
Where are you?
hair.
Strip searches.
Which one first, sir?
Ryan.
How are you going? Going to Grimley?
Yeah.
Bad man. But yourself?
The nut walker.
Come on, Ryan. Off the equator. Don't knock me around. It's just that I remember you from Bendigo, yeah? That's your name? Now, you're a real top of Bendigo.
How on?
Yeah, sure. You can hear me if you like.
How on? Have a bit of gas leak for us.
Let yourself go. Search us in slow motion.
Yeah, that's something we got plenty of. Come on.
Gee. Why don't you take those crows into that pump?
Much better off down here.
It'll be like Marcel Marceau.
When you require these, this exquisite carol,
no effect.
I know where I'd like to stick them, sir. Examine the anus. Bendo.
Let me have a look.
I'll park down on, sir. I haven't got my glasses on. Look it up. Look it up.
Nothing. Absolutely nothing, sir. Like a jolly one.
Negative.
Affirmative.
Stretch out your arms, Ryan, and turn around. Do your famous impression of Christ again.
But forgive them, for they know not what they do.
Not a mark on him, is he?
No, sir.
What?
No, sir.
Speak up.
Not a mark. Not a mark or fruit, sir.
And that's the way he's going to stay. We got him like this, he stays like this. Not a mark on him.
Feeling something high once someone to serve? Because of Oxholson, you know? He's the one who did it. He shot our fellow officer. He slaughtered our mate George. What are you going to do about it, sir?
You do ace with him, sir. Well, cut it out. Come on!
You know they're guarded at Richmond now, are we?
Ace with me. On to the inquiry, prisoner. Off the way.
Now we've got the four out of that.
Prison issue, prisoner. Prison issue, don't mind.
We're doing the fire at the pen there, next.
He's sitting to his back, sir.
You're next, Walker. Drop him.
You could nickname go. Almost made it to the Tokyo Olympics. Second in the open beer bottle. Nothing there again, sir. How disappointing.
Hard to work getting changed, don't
it? Ace
of it. The mic's still clear. Ace of it. Immediately. Do you understand me?
You know, all it took him to get out of here was a hook, two mop handles, a few bedspreads, an Irish Catholicism, a perverse adoration of failure. Nothing can stamp that out once the rot set in.
He's finished. There's something faded about him.
Yeah, the old boy doesn't change a bit, has it? Got me, isn't it? isn't it? The architecture. Oh, Gothic aura.
Sit down here, I can get you, mate.
What?
A last supper.
We're in the same boat, aren't we?
Nah. You need some new shoes, mate.
Do I?
Hate to be in yours.
Now, don't get sentimental on me. Hey, Premier Bolton's getting enough mileage out of it, isn't he? Have you heard him on the television? I mean, he's the mad dog, not me.
Hey, did you invent this? This two-way phone bloody communication thing?
What, a two-way toilet? It's an old invention called society. Just like talking to the press. Funny how I think of journalists. In here.
I can hear you. Perfect, mate. Perfect through the belt of time.
Yeah. We'll escape again. You in your way, me in mine. Catridge is the state of mind, or didn't you know that? Yeah. Keep your chin up. Always keep your chin up. I've always been interested in courage. They can't come near you when you have that. Whatever it is.
We couldn't do any more, can mate? So-called decent people can't understand it.
Yeah, that's right. So-called decent people. What the ogres you taught me at the boys' home, pricks.
We're committed.
Committed? Mate, we're bloody terminal.
What do you dream of tonight, mate?
I don't know. The mighty Murrumbidgee. The boys' home at Sunbury. What a joke.
Night, mate.
Yeah. Night, mate.
Who do you love, Rob?
The Lord Jesus Christ.
You're nothing more than your father.
No.
Yes.
Who do you love? My brother. My father. My sisters I love. And then anyone else is around.
You know how lucky you are to be a guest at this Catholic boy's home, Ron.
Yes. Yeah, I've got a pretty fair idea.
The Lord Jesus must laugh at you, Ronald. He must fill his step inside and laugh at you.
I hope so. I don't care if he laughs at me. Oh, I like the sound of his laughing voice, as a matter of fact. I like the sound of his laughter. You know what? It's not me you're flogging.
Flogging yourself. If my old man was alive, he'd kick you to death, you peanut! Ah, but your old man is not alive, is it? You're not that angry to run, are you? Are you? Are you?
You'll never come back.
Show us home, I'd like that. Kick your dying! movie you need to keep the way things are developing. I've got a trial coming up. And what hope have I got? I know I'm in for it. Feels inevitable. Contact me. I called you when we were in Richmond, but the phone was fucked. I only got to say hello. I bet you they heard that at D24. I mean, was it really that difficult with me? I mean, did you suffer, girly, did you? But I was a good provider, wasn't I? We had a lot of excitement, didn't we? In our old shack in Richmond.
Dorothy, what's the matter? You look upset.
Excuse me while I chuck.
Did you do this to her? You're a disgrace to the Victorian police force and humanity. You're a disgrace to everything.
Ron isn't here, Mr. Slater. He's never here. I don't know where he is. I'm at it.
Come on, Dorothy, it's not that bad.
He seems so normal. I live in a tornado.
Is Ron into diamonds, is he? He'd do anything to satisfy his gambling habit. He'd even stoop for murder. You listen to me, you piece of shit. You got no right to come in here and torment this respectable lady. You clean this mess up right now and I'll kick you to death, you got it? Now you say sorry. Sorry, lady.
I thought you were going to be a good father, a good provider. I never know where you are. You keep saying that's the way you like it. It's not good enough, Ron. Oh, I love you. But you're a mystery to me. Strange, hopeless, a punter. What warehouse are you in tonight? You may as well sleep there. I thought I was all you wanted. I thought you were giving your horse an apple at the races last month. You even joked that he bit you. But you were doping him. So I bit you. You want the poison. Oh, it'll fester if it's not seen to. I'll fester. I'm not seen to. Oh, Danny, where are you? Don't you care about me? That girly? I thought we were friends.
Thank you. X and all those little X's and little puppy dog X and cat X.
Shamefaced, and what we mean. So, right, old boy, how's your wife, Mrs. Wright?
She's all right, but can we get to the point?
The National Grocery Store job last night was the work of a one Ronnie Ryan and his three fellows. I'm front of heat next week, and if you speak to the prosecutor for me, I'll tell you where old Ronnie Boy's hiding out.
Oh, Jesus, God. What are you saying? Oh, yeah. Now, where's he hiding out?
Here's an aerial view of Richmond.
Alright, now I recognise Swan Street. What's that street?
Chapel Street.
Is mine hiding in Chapel Street?
Keep going down it. To the river. The Yarra. The Yarra River.
Oh, just tell me his address.
Well, he wants to be a pagan.
Well, he is a peasant, isn't he?
It's only a wish.
What's involved?
It's just basically registering a car.
You know, Father, some of the worst murderers in here are Baptists.
I wonder why that is.
This is their music that presses them.
Good question.
Ryan's wife was church anymore, wasn't she? What was her name?
Mrs. Ryan?
The old name. He didn't have a first name, a Christian name. Why doesn't she come and see him?
Well, they have a divorce.
They don't account for it.
If Ryan had married a Rick from Preston, he wouldn't be in here. He married out of his past, didn't he?
There may be something in that. But the way he was going, it would have been impossible for him to marry beneath him. He would have had to marry a dead greyhound.
Once a Catholic, always a Catholic.
Who said that?
Me, just then.
Converted today, if you like, Father.
Well, what's he like, Miss Ryan? No one knows much about him, do they?
Staunch? Amusing. Funny? Funny peculiar. But not violent. Unpredictable. A fool. And a student of philosophy. He's probably had too much Catholic boys' home. Permanent brain damage.
Right, I'll see you.
Thanks, Mark.
Got a quarry beside me.
Look, have my Bible. Keep it. You know, read it again.
What's this paper you got marking your spot? For the newspaper.
That's race results from Caulfield. Last night, Zeros.
Yeah. Hey, see, there's a horse race tomorrow called Son of Man. You reckon you could put a unit on each way for me, Father? Good name for a horse, isn't it? Don't you reckon?
Son of Man.
Son of Man, okay.
Son of Man.
Does that finding and those inferences mean that Ryan, knowing that Walker had committed the felony created by Section 35 of the Jails Act 1958, and knowing that Hodson was attempting to arrest Walker, therefore intentionally used force which resulted in Hodson's death to prevent him from making that arrest. That coupled with the fact that Hodson was, in the above circumstances, lawfully authorised to make the arrest of Walker. We have already observed that the conviction of Walker in charging.
You have put out conceding the charter aircraft, did you not?
Yes, sir, Mr. Oakhurst, sir.
And the only people aboard were the policemen and the accused?
Yes, sir.
Apart from the crew?
Apart from the crew.
How many police were aboard?
Fair few.
Apart from the crew?
Apart from the crew.
Yeah. And were there police from homicide?
Apart from the crew, yes, I do believe there were four.
What type of aircraft was it?
Big.
Or can you be more specific?
Fokker Friendship.
A what?
That's what type of aircraft it was, a Fokker Friendship.
That's a two-engine aircraft, is it not?
Yes, sir.
What were those seating arrangements?
Two in the front, two in the back.
Did you engage in conversation with Detective Morrison?
Yes, sir.
Well, what subjects did you philosophize about?
Vietnam, social justice, economics, capital punishment and football.
You were airborne at the time?
Yes, sir.
Halfway to Canberra?
I don't know about Canberra, but yeah, we're up in the air.
Why did you circle less than an airport?
There wasn't a way we circled less than an airport.
You circled it several times, but you put down at Laverton.
No, put down at Laverton.
The jury directed that the Crown must prove that Ryan killed Hodson and that the killing amounted to murder. For these reasons, we are of the opinion the appeal cannot succeed.
Tell me how you escaped.
Well, I've been stuck in the booth for yonks. The end of 64 this was. Well, I've had enough. I mean, some people can do more or less can. I found it impossible for me to rot. My wife had divorce proceedings just up to me and H. Now, I happen to love family. So it was either one thing or the other. And then it came to me.
Liberty. The result is that in law, the case was of constructive murder by Ryan.
Let us now speak of the trajectory of the bullet.
You're wasting your breath, mate.
You would have had to have been 9 feet tall to shot Hodson, wouldn't you? If Ryan did not fire that shot, then who did? I once start with the evidence of Dr. McNamara, the pathologist. This evidence cannot be contravened and shows that the bullet entered Hodson's body 1 inch above the right clavicle. It travelled from right to left, from front to back, and emerged at a point 7 inches to the left and 1 inch lower, as measured from the soles of the feet, than the point of entry.
Have you any reason why the sentence of death should not be passed upon you?
Why not? It's all been leading to this.
If Hodson was standing upright at an angle of 90 degrees to the roadway, as some witnesses suppose, then it was mathematically demonstrable that Ryan, being inches shorter than Hodson, could not have fired the shot which travelled downward through Hodson's body, as
the result ever has had to disclose the case was
that
a constructive murder by Ryan,
body and because of that in a great part of those throughout his body
that Ryan,
he wanted to
miss the... No, Emily! Will ever listen to you!
you something. Judge, old boy. How did you feel when you sentenced me to death, Mr. Stark, sir?
Some good soul handed me a glass of whiskey, if you must know.
I reckon the wrong bloke got it, if you must know.
How was the flight down?
What are you talking to me, an angel? Ah, the flight down from Sydney. Well, the coppers lied their heads off, but you know what they're like better than anybody, eh, Jack?
Well, they must be good at something, I suppose. Well, all the best, dear boy. See you in the next room. I mean, life.
Made it possible for myself and my sister to leave the Good Shepherd Convent in Abbotsford, where we stayed almost 6 years. Even now, I still recall how Ron turned exhausted after weeks spent out bush cutting sleepers. For his mother and sisters to have a simple, decent home, food and clothing. And for myself and my sister to finish our education in the familiar surroundings.
Ron Ryan got the external exam leaving certificate at the end of 1962. He passed. He suffered at the Bendigo training prison. All the mail came in weekly and I sorted through the students' work. There were a variety of pupils, from tots to criminals, ex-servicemen and women, even disabled pupils from Urella and Tirana. Every single year I had a record book with the name of every student written down. If a person was in prison, I drew four vertical lines next to their name, to indicate prison bus, for my own reference. I suppose it was a kind of code. I did a blue wave if they were in the Navy, a red cross if they were overseas, and so on. When was my age? His writing was very neatly presented, right-handed. His grammar was excellent, and his essays always well paragraphed. That's how we knew each other. It was in the letters, and Ron responded well to encouragement. He passed. He must have read about it in the Herald. The very first thing he wrote fell into the title of Myself and My Environment. Ron spoke of the great love he had for his three daughters.
My brother took on the great responsibility of father, son and brother when my invalid father could no longer support him. Surely this showed him to be a warm, unselfish human being, not a cold-blooded killer. We can all attest to one's love and family affection, which leaves it impossible to accept the fact that mother's son and our dearest brother, my pain.
Well, I work for you, Mr. Johnson. Tim McCutton and Tree Fallon. You stood out. Wages you paid me were good. Decent fella. £35 a week. Even 40. You're a good worker, Ron. A good home man.
Yeah. Every second weekend there for a while with the kids. And girly. Sometimes you get on the other end of the store with me. She had kids in the bushes. I always managed to get her to hospital on time. Did my best by her.
Ron's a cut above most fellas. Can't bring back any of their names. But you're a mate. I'll remember you, Ryan.
Thanks, Keith.
You organised the blokes good and kept an accurate record of 2 days of them. You kept yourself clean and tidy, and all your tools in very good order.
You'll have me crying in a minute. What about you, Mr. Harding, with the police company? I mean, what have you got to say about him?
Ah, the officer first arrested you.
Jesus, that'll get you a beer.
I wouldn't drink it, Ron. We called you homing pigeon. We're just so obviously coming back to you now.
Yeah. Orchard. Yep, the Michelangelo of the Warner Bull racetrack.
Check no very good, Ron. I'll have to do better than that in the Warner Bull 430 Corona area.
What was I like?
You're tough. Impossible question. Drinking less iron, having quite severe alteration in childhood. Intelligent, hobby, fitness and wear out. An unusual crew. 31 before you committed your first offence. Got your leaving and matric in jail, didn't you?
Yeah, leaving and matric. They're still being good stead, haven't they? Where would I be without? Yeah, I'll give me a look when I think about it.
You were a mug, mate.
Thanks, Brian.
Some dropped out. Futility, I suppose. But not Ronald. He didn't whitewash himself. No attempt to. He readily admitted he was a petty criminal. Hanging touch with emotionally. He was so perceptive. The potential. I used to look forward to marking his papers. I gave him 88 once, but mostly he was in the high 70s. Ron Ryan passed Form 5 English from inside Bendigo. I walked to work the day he died, through the Treasury Gardens. About 10 of his teachers sat around a big desk, listening silently to the radio. I sat with my head in my hands and kept sobbing.
In closing, I can only say we live in hope and pray the powers that be to exist to grant my brother clemency. We, his loving family and numerous friends, are still deeply distressed over the grave doubt which arose in his actual part in the unfortunate incident. Yours sincerely, Gloria Ryan.
And hence would appreciate your intercession on my behalf for your prayers. I have a fairly resilient nature, which enables me to make the best, which enables me to maintain reasonable spirit and make the best of any bad situation. I employ my time by reading, playing chess, a little quiet prayer. Thanks to the gypsy fruitcake.
I never thought I'd see you again.
Me either.
Why didn't you write? When I write to you...
I don't enjoy writing. I'm remarried. I'm dead. Die having a cup of tea with you.
Oh.
How are you?
That's a shame. That's one thing I really believe in here, Reed. Not even a friendly word. Any word off, but not a word from you. And you wouldn't let me see the kids, would you? All that didn't write to me. When you tried to put me in, I thought you cared about me!
Getting out of hand, Ron! There's a big difference between knocking over a butcher shop and killing someone.
You should have answered my letter. That was heartless!
What? Hey, killing someone isn't heartless. David, let's not argue. There's not much time. Oh, let me look at you. Oh, God. God, what are they feeding him on, Ron? You're so pale. You're so pale. Are you going to talk to me? Do you forgive me?
Thank you.
to call them the daughters of the devil. Jen grew past the door, didn't she? She likes a coach, doesn't she? He's a bloke. I keep seeing him, you know? Seeing him and smelling the hair. My Bible every day. Ordinary thing. Just ordinary thing.
home.
Not too much. You said yourself, man. Courage. They can't touch you if you've got courage. You're better off in here. Sometimes I wish I was going there with you. 20 years since the last hanging in Victoria. Why did I get into you? I don't understand. Why not, Peter? Thank you.
Breakfast shortly, Ron. Bake him in. Here's a look for it.
Wouldn't mind a walk in the park, mate. Don't mind if I do. Cheers.
Put these on, Ron. They don't disgrace themselves.
Can't keep secrets in here.
How do you mean?
I'm sorry to hear about your mum, Ken.
Hardly the right time to talk about that one.
Look, mate, I know I'm going in the lion pit. Hey, they tell me, what do you see when you get to heaven, Screw?
How do you feel, Ron?
Not bad for a young bloke. What are you up to?
Would you like me to say mass for you, Ron?
Don't feel like that.
Nobody passes the city, spares the sanctity.
I mean,
since we were on Saturday, today I'm going to certificate you. It's an angry state. It's always the kind of one.
Five wait, Mr. Greenlight, sir. 5-2. I know, Mr. Fraser. I know the time. 5-2. Show the press in. 14 reporters. Make them hand in their invites. No smoking. No tape recorders. That wouldn't be cricket. Tell them to stand to attention.
Thank you.
I think Mr. Grindley wants to vote if you know.
I'll be all right, Cap. Made my peace with God.
I think I'll make it.
I do.
You'll always have a friend up there.
I'm so sorry, Ron. So sorry about all of this.
I'm sorry for you, Mr. Grindley. But it had to be. You were good to me. I liked you. And praying for you too. And a lot of prayers lately. All round. I'll be all right. What about you? You know, it's got me under a hell of a lot of pressure. Goodbye. And thank you. Never forget. No matter how long you live, you were ordained for me, right? Keep up the good work, Gar. And you can quote me. Christ showed us how to die on the cross. And our Lord forgives sinners.
Thank you.
You can see the fence in it, can't you?
Yeah. Easier to hold the piss and shit out.
And blood. Don't forget the blood.
Blood?
Was there any blood? What do you think that is? Red paint?
Right. Good blood.
Just makes sense stripping them up over the other trip. That's all I'm saying.
Didn't they always think of that?
All over in a second. All that fuss.
For a petty crib.
Like him. Nothing much to remember, is there?
About what?
About a man.
A man like him, you mean?
Yep. Nothing much to remember about someone like him.
He's different.
Is he?
People will remember him.
And what makes you say that?
Remember what they did to him.
Hanged him like a dog. Is that what they'll remember about him?
He had history. He lived. He was a man, a married man.
That's his history, is it? He had kids, didn't he?
Three young girls. Three sisters and a big old mum.
What if he did shoot him?
There's just something about him, that's all.
Did you, ever meet him or speak to him?
No.
Then what's there to remember, mate? He was a petty crim who stole hundreds of mobiles and kept them in his warehouse.
He was kind. Something there was good in him, but not burglary. No one can sanctify him or resurrect him. Christ forgive him. I see him most nights when I pray for him. The spirit of his mother. The pathological hatred of authority. Why were we friends? So different. I watched him go through. I was standing from here to where you are. I could have reached out and touched his shoulder. I had him body searched when he came back from Sydney. My people wanted to fix him up for shooting Hodson. I said when he hangs, he will be as clean as that. And he was. Not a mark on him when he was hanged. Clean as a whistle. Clean soul inside him. I pray for you, Ron. Someone has to. You and George Hodson. I knew you both. Remember Ronald Ryan.